Hi everyone and welcome back to a new art journal project. Today I'm going to use a new set of dies to create your very own art journal. This is a mini one and it is about 5x5 if you are wondering on the size, without taking in consideration that pointy top. It's from her new collection, which is called Archie Arabia, and there is one more set of dies to help you create mini art journals, which is more square. So for today, I'm going to work with this one and let's take a look at the dies. This is the cover one and it gives you that lovely shape. You can fold it and create your cover. And there are also little holes here where you can thread through your elastic. In this die set, you will find another big die, which is similar to the shape, but without the holes and slightly smaller. This is meant to use to cut out your pages. And the set comes with even more dies. These are two dies that you can place one inside the other to create a window. And I will be working with them today. There are some decorative elements like borders and different shapes, and this is a big one that is going to create a lovely window. It fits lovely inside. It doesn't cut out all around, but if you want to create a panel that you can use the other die. All the die sets by Art by Marlene that create mini art journals sell out super quickly, so if you like this one, check it out and grab it as soon as you can. Now, I am going to use 4 leather by Art by Marlene again. It comes in different colors and I will be working with the golden one, and there is another pack with 3 more colors depending on what you like to do. These are really easy to die cut. I will be using these thin dies to run them through my die cutting machine and you will see that it's going to cut it out like butter. I believe this faux leather creates the perfect cover for your art journals, and you will see how I'm going to work with it today. Now I'm going to use my Gemini for cutting out the faux leather, just because the die is quite big. However, if you do have the basic Spellbinder or Sizzix die cutting machine, fear not, the die is going to fit just fine. All you have to do is to lay the material and the die like this. Once you run it through, then move them together and run it one more time. So I'm going to bring in my Gemini platform, lay on top the golden faux leather, and then on top the die. I'm quite frugal with this page, so I'm arranging it all the way to the left. This way I will have enough area on the right if I want to die cut something extra. Now I am playing with the different elements from the die to try and decide what I want to use on the front to decorate it. I finally went with this one to create a lovely window. I'm going to secure everything on top with some washi tape running through my die cutting machine, and here is the outcome. Now that I have the cover, I'm going to use the other die, which is slightly smaller, to die cut my pages. For that, I'm going with heavy watercolor paper. The one that I like to use is by Arteza, and you will find it linked down below. I like it because it's quite thick, it takes water and lots of different mediums nicely, and it doesn't warp. And now I'm ready to assemble my book. Here is my front cover. And I did use the other die 4 times, which means that once I put everything together, I will end up having 16 pages front and back. Before I put it together, notice that the cover is quite flimsy and I want to stabilize it somehow, so I die cut one more time the pages. I'm going to cut it in 2 separate pieces and I'm going to use them as a backing, stick it at the back of the cover, front and back. This way I will not have a soft cover, but it really depends on what you want your book to look like. And since I'm going to stick one of those pages at the back of my front cover, then that gives me the opportunity to create a little scene that you can see through the window at the front. So I'm using my pencil just to make a mark on where this window is going to fall once I stick it. And now I know exactly where I need to create my little scene. Now you can work with any medium that you like. Since I made all these pages out of watercolor paper, I can go with acrylics, I can go with inks, I can go with anything I like, with sprays. I decided to go with my Distress Oxide inks here and I'm mixing 3 different colors in a shade of blue, plus a little bit of black towards the top. I'm going for a night sky, which is going to show through that window. After some quick blending, I'm going to lay on top the cover and see how it looks, and I was super happy with that. So I'm going to move on and do some die cutting. Now this is a little mini art journal book that I am creating for playing with the new collection by Art by Marlene, the Archie Arabia collection. So that's why I love, absolutely love that shape. And for the front, I'm going to use a die set that gives you all those little houses. There are even palm trees that you can mix and match. There is a moon, stars. So finally, I picked one palace, a palm tree that I die cut from black cardstock, and then the moon and the stars that I die cut from yellow cardstock. Now I'm going to use some glue at the back and stick them down, making sure that they show through the window. This way I am creating a night scene, and I'm going to embellish it with the stars and the moon on my sky. Now if you notice, this die cuts out the windows as well as the doors. If you are going with a colorful color scheme, then of course you can use multiple colors to put this little palace together. Since I'm going for a night scene, I decided to use just yellow for some of the windows, and the rest of them I just filled them in with black. The moon has some tiny stars hanging from it. I'm not going to use them, so I just chopped them with my scissors. Now I'm going to put my moon down as well as a few of the stars. And if you are new to art journaling, I think that this size of mini art journals is perfect for you, just because you don't have to cover up a big area. You can be creative every day by creating something small, especially if you come from the card making world, then you do have whatever you need, the supplies, the stamps, the inks, to create little projects just for you. Now on the pages that I die cut, I went with black gesso at the back, and I'm using some double-sided tape all around so that I can stick them together. You can use any type of glue. I just found that this double-sided tape worked just fine, and keep in mind that the back of this faux leather feels like felt. So here it is, nice and sturdy. As you can see, it's not flimsy at all, so I ended up having a hard cover. Now all I need to do is to thread the elastic, and I think black would go perfectly with my color scheme. However, I didn't have any. Make sure that this doesn't end up too tight, since you need to be able to put the pages in and out easily. To finish off my front, I'm going to use a phrase from the sticker book that says, "This is where magic happens." I'm going to stick it on top of black cardstock just to make it more sturdy. This way I can glue it down on the faux leather. And finally, I did use my white gel pen to add some details, both on the phrase as well as on the shape of the actual book. Now I have my mini journal ready to go, and I can create a little page anytime I have some time. However, I was so into it when I created the book that I couldn't help it, and I went ahead and created two pages for the inside. So I'm going to share them with you today. I'm working on four pages at the same time. For this one, I'm going to work with gloss spray by Dina Weekly. This is acrylic paint, so it dries permanent, and I find that these sprays are slightly clogged, but they still work. I was too lazy to go to the sink and clean up the nozzles, so just went with it, and I think that they looked just fine. Here I'm spraying some water to help them move and blend together, and I will repeat the same thing on the back. So I will end up having four pages with backgrounds on one go. So I'm going to work on one of them, and I'm bringing in one of the newest stencils that gives you this lovely design. I'm going to place it on one side, and I will go over it with black soot. I usually like to frame my art journals by having some darker sides. I usually like to frame my journal somehow by having darker edges, and that's what I'm going for here. However, you will see that later on I will change my mind, and I do change my mind many times while I am creating my art journal pages. And this is where you will be able to see the beauty of working on top of glossy sprays. So anyway, I will come back to that later. I'm just continuing adding bits and pieces on the background. This time I'm working with a white pen, and this is acrylic paint marker. I'm going through some of the designs from the stencil. I'm not going to go over the whole design. I'm just picking bits and pieces here and there. So now this is where I remove the stencil. I like how that white stenciled areas look, and I didn't like the black one. Now from the die cut booklets from this collection, I picked a couple of palm trees as well as the palace. And if you notice, the shape of this palace is the exact same one as the one that I have on the front cover. But however, this is enlarged and already colored. There is also a stamp set that gives you these so that you can customize it and make it your own. Now I'm creating my little scene with the palace, the couple of palm trees, and I'm really happy with the outcome, nice and colorful. I'm sticking everything down with my Nouveau Deluxe glue, but again, use whatever glue you like. And now let's go ahead and remove that black that I didn't like. I'm working with a baby wipe, and I can just wipe off all that black soot that I have there. That's because the background is a non-porous surface and it is kind of glossy. I did use Gloss Acrylics by Dina Weekly, which is actually acrylic paint, so it is really easy to remove it. Now I'm bringing in some more elements that I popped out from those Archie Arabia booklets, and I'm sticking down a couple of borders. Just to make everything nice and neat, I'm using my scissors to cut off any excess paper. And I did pop out some lovely dots in different colors and shapes. They look like small mandalas, and I think that they are going to add something whimsical on my page. I made sure that all of them are in different color. And I love this collection so much. The design makes me feel as if Aladdin with his flying carpet is going to pop out of my page at any moment. Like always, I'm going to add some highlights here and there, and I'm not using any black lines around the design. There are black lines already, and before I stick them down, I forgot to show that on camera. I did go around the edges with a black pen, a black marker, which is something that I like to do to get rid of that white edge. I'm adding some white highlights here and there, and I'm using a white paint marker. This is from the Jane Davenport collection. I did use it previously in another video and I loved them, so I'm gonna keep using them a lot, and you will see them in popping in my videos again and again. And now it's time for the quote. For that, again, I'm picking one of the stickers from the sticker book, and I went with "Stop to see the beauty along the way." I like to chop it in smaller parts and stick it down, and then I go all around it with a black marker. Again, the black pen that I'm using here comes from a set that includes 10 different black pens. These are the Fine Liners by Jane Davenport. Love them, and I will keep using them. So here is the one with the black and white paint marker. So this is the one with the 10 different nibs that I'm talking about. And you can see here some close-up photos on the first page for today. Now today I'm going to share one more page from my mini art journal, and if you want to see even more Archie Arabia pages for this book, let me know in the comments below. So this time I went with my Distress Oxide inks for a completely different look. This is going to be more muted, although I'm using very bright colors. Remember, Distress Oxide sprays never dry as bright as you see them now. They are going to be very muted and they will have that chalky finish once they dry out. If you want to keep that vibrancy, go with dilution sprays, for example. These are going to stay nice and bright. Now I'm working on the back again with the same colors. These are Fired Brick and Spiced Marmalade. And once again, with one go, I end up having four backgrounds. Now I'm going to spray on top with Wild Honey, and I'm bringing in this lovely design. This is a new stencil, I believe it's number 14. They don't have names, they do have just numbers, but you will find linked everything down below, so check them out. At one go, I am adding stenciling on both pages, so I have something ready to go for another day. And I am going to add some splashes, just to add some more interest on the background. And I'm using for that both Fired Brick as well as Spiced Marmalade, which are the colors that I used for the background. So for this page, I decided to have those lanterns as my focal point. I'm going to pop out some of them. And when you are using those die-cut booklets, you cannot have a quicker and easier art journal page. Just pick different bits and pieces. They are guaranteed to match together since they are made from the same designer, same color combos, and they work lovely together. Before I go ahead and stick everything down, I'm repeating the same technique that I did for the first page. So I'm using again the same stencil and I'm going over it with a thin white gel pen. I love having white details on my background and I usually add them by adding some white splashes. For this page, I decided not to add white splashes. However, I do add some white through those stencils. And now it's time to stick all my lanterns down. For that, again, I'm using my Nouveau Deluxe glue. I'm making sure that they are not all in a row. Some are up and some are down, just to make it look more interesting. And once everything is down, I'm going to use a ruler and draw some strings with my black thin pen. And if you want to add extra texture on your page, you can of course use some thread instead of those black lines. And here's another idea, you can make something similar, Christmas themed, if you have some different stamps with ornaments, Christmas ornaments, that you can hang from the top of your art journal page. Now it's time for my favorite highlights. I'm going to add them here and there. I just like the whimsical look that this gives and they look as if they are shining. In the sticker book there is a phrase that says keep looking where the light pours in, and I think that's the perfect sentiment to go with a page with lanterns. So again I'm going to cut it smaller and stick it down. Now since the background on these stickers is black, I'm going to highlight it with white all around. And I'm going to call this page done. Both pages for today are really quick and simple to create, but you'll have lots of fun making them. So it's time to put my little book together. I'm going to place one inside the other, as well as the two other empty pages, and then thread them through the elastic. Below in the description area you will find links to everything I used. The whole Art by Marlene Archie Arabia collection is available at Joggles at the moment. And here is a quick flip through on my mini art journal where you can see the finished pages as well as the 6 more backgrounds that I have ready to go for another creative session. So I hope that you had fun today, that you got inspired. Let me know in the comments if you want to see the rest of the pages that I will create for this mini art journal book. Thank you all so much for spending some time with me today, and I hope you will all have a lovely week.